Wrestling. All-Star Wrestling is sanctioned by the AWA, the American Wrestling Association. All-Star Wrestling presents the top professional wrestlers from the United States, Canada, England, Germany, Australia, Mexico, Poland, Japan, the greatest professional wrestlers from throughout the world. And now to the ring for All-Star Action.
Hi, I'm Greg Gagne.
And I'm Vern Gagne.
Welcome to the AWA Legends. And today we've got a giant legend for you. And Dad, we're talking about Andre the Giant. Obviously, what do you have on?
This is one of his shirts, of course, that we had for the Battle Royal that he was in.
1983.
First time I met Andre the Giant was in Japan. Went down to Hiroshima and took a train. And the promoter on the train with us said, come, I got to introduce you to someone. So I went into the car he was in. We knocked on the door. I looked in, and here was a man, a large, large man in a Japanese bunk, which is not exactly long. But his legs are up on one side of the wall, and his head and shoulders and arms are up on the other side of the wall. And it was the most funniest thing I'd seen in a long time, and I couldn't help burst out laughing. But it was Andre the Giant in a Japanese bunk.
Well, you know, for me in Japan, I know the beds even then were a little bit too small. My feet hung over the end. Well, you didn't have that problem, did you?
I didn't have that problem.
No, I didn't.
But Andre the Giant had that problem. And, of course, he was a happy giant all the time.
All the time.
And he was a great, great wrestler.
And
great athlete all the way around. He was a soccer player. He was a boxer. I had a high esteem of him as an athlete.
And we've got some highlights of Andre the Giant today. Battle Royals, possibly. You know, he was a big man, and those fingers on him, remember the ring size?
Yes.
That's what really was remarkable to me. Silver dollar would fit right through that ring.
That's right. And he backed up everything that he said he could do, and if you looked at him, you knew he could do it.
Well, we'll be back with more of Andre the Giant right after this.
You're bonding.
Grant has a good hold on the Giant's hair. And now Ed Francis getting in there trying to stomp on Blackwell. They got at least on Blackwell's hand to get it loose from the hair of the Giant. And a headbutt by Blackwell. On the ropes, referee calling for a break. Will he get it? I'm telling. Blackwell is shagged over to the other side of the ring, cautioned by the referee. Andre the Giant gets up. The big Frenchman, he is mad. Good Lord, is he big. And when he talks, sounds like he's talking in a cave. Remember now, $5,000 slam contest here. $5,000 going to either man. To either man who can body slam the other. Side headlock. I'll tell you, as I told you before, oh, look out, right into the rope. A jump over by Blackwell, using the other rope, and a boom! He runs right into the Giant. Like running into the caboose of a freight train. Blackwell slow to get in the ring. He must get in that ring before the count of 10. Forearm smash. Look out now. An Irish whip into the ropes. A back body drop by Blackwell. Boy, oh boy, that took some strength. A cover. One. And the Giant throws Blackwell off. Bodyslam attempt. He didn't do it. There's a cover there by the Giant and a throw off by Blackwell. Let me reconstruct that for you just a bit. Blackwell went for the body slam. You saw he couldn't lift him at that time. Now here goes Andre. And he body slams Blackwell. 5,000 dollars. $5,000 to the Giants. $5,000 to the Giant. Oh, holy smokes, and Blackwell goes after him. A whip coming. Blackwell in the turnbuckles on the other side. The ring about collapsed. And there's the boot. Andre chops Blackwell. Headbutts him. An Irish whip again. Straight in. Oh! In a hole, he threw him over the ropes. Wait a minute, Andre. Andre threw Blackwell over the top rope. And he can't believe it. I know he realizes what he did just now. He lost the match, but he won $5,000.
Hi, this is Greg.
Post. Patera headbutt on Duncum. The Heenan family's in there. En masse. And look at this, Bockwinkel.
This man, Bobby Duncum.
From behind, Heenan didn't face Andre. Oh! He jumped out.
Bobby Heenan.
Heenan jumped out.
Heenan
bailed out. Nobody threw him. Andre wants to go after him. Oh. Andre wants to go after Heenan. Heenan just plainly jumped over the top rope.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andre the Giant has been eliminated from the Battle Royal.
What?
Andre the Giant out from the Battle Royal.
Andre the Giant went over the top rope, too. Look out. Bockwinkel, Patera. They try to double team on. Oh! Andre the Giant goes back in. I don't think he got eliminated. He got out of the ring. Apparently he's out. Look at this. The Hulk throws Bockwinkel is out. Patera goes over. Here's the Hulk. The Incredible Hulk. It's official. The Incredible Hulk Hogan, the winner. But the
winner tonight, the Incredible Hulk Hogan.
congratulated now by Andre the Giant.
Well, right now, Mean Gene, I declare war on the whole Bobby Heenan family because I'm the chairman of the board of the Hulkster's crowd. But you know something? Mean Gene said no more of that. Well, since all spirit love war in professional wrestling, I declare war, and I'm going to bring in the heavy artillery, Daddy. I'm bringing in the heavy artillery.
Oh, my word.
And here he is right
holy
here.
Cow,
how heavy can you get? Here he is, the heavy artillery.
It doesn't come any heavier than Andre the Giant.
It's not Orca Mania anymore.
That's a Giant Mania.
All right, Giant Mania.
Giant,
yes, sir.
We're the two biggest one, right? You are the Giant.
Well, I'll tell you, that's
I'm making a Giant.
You're going to make him a Giant, Andre?
Yes, sir. He's the Giant.
Gentlemen, I'll
We're
tell you.
We're the only two Giant in professional wrestling.
That's right. Have you ever seen a cannon like this, huh?
I tell you, this is a shock to me. I could hardly believe what the Bobby Heenan family is going to say. They are certainly going to be shocked beyond imagination,
Ladies,
all right, World War III.
It's a big announcement. The Hulk picking Andre the Giant to be Duncum, Patera, and Nick Bockwinkel. More after this. Stay tuned.
All right, boss.
Man, I can't believe it, gentlemen. I can't.
Rod, it looks as though Andre the Giant wants Bobby Heenan. Only Bobby Heenan.
Well, in a recent battle royal, Bobby Heenan got Andre the Giant's goat, and Andre the Giant stepped over the top rope and onto the floor, which automatically eliminated him from the bout as he was going after Bobby the Brain Heenan. So he still has that in the back of his mind. There's the introduction of Leo Nomalini. Talk about a man who has his work cut out. Nomalini certainly falls into that category. It may be too much for one man.
You've seen it.
We're ready to go. Bockwinkel, Duncum, Patera, and Heenan against the incredible Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant. And now, Andre and the Hulk have three members of the Heenan family all bottled up in the corner, that being Duncum, Patera, and Bockwinkel. And out of the ring now goes Patera, being thrown out. A headbutt drives Bockwinkel to the canvas from Andre the Giant. Hulk looking to tag off with Andre the Giant. And here it comes after Andre's size 18 boot said hello to the face of Big Bad Bobby Duncum. Watch. Nick Bockwinkel reaching in, trying to assist Big Bad Bobby Duncum. Andre the Giant saying, get up, get up. He helps him up. Smashed with that Giant right arm. Nobody wants to go in against Andre the Giant. The Heenan family, they do not stand alone. They stand together, but not any one of the four wants a piece of Andre the Giant at this time. Well, somebody's going to have to come in. Heenan shaking his head, saying, no, 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 it's not going to be him. Now Bockwinkel, the heavyweight champion, is in, talking with Patera as the Giant waits in the center of the ring. Takes a couple of steps toward Nick Bockwinkel. Bockwinkel now with a headlock. One way, a different way to get the win taken out. The crowd loves it.
Looking at the Giant reminds me of Rock and Roll Drumhoff. You see the movement he's giving there once in a while?
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Marty O'Neill, along with Rod Trongard, yours truly, Rod Trongard, here at ringside. Andre the Giant and the Hulk Hogan against Bockwinkel, Duncum, Patera, and Heenan, and it's been Hogan and the Giant so far in this one. A 1 hour time limit, one fall. The Giant working on Bockwinkel, and now the Giant pulling Bockwinkel across the ring and Ken Patera into the ring. Patera was trying to hold on to and somehow rescue Bockwinkel to no avail. The strength of this Andre the Giant is incredible as he works over Bockwinkel in the corner and motions Patera to come on over and join the fun. Patera, correction, Bockwinkel, driving fists into the stomach of Andre the Giant. No effect whatsoever. Bockwinkel takes a hard right hand from the Hulk Hogan outside the ring. Let's see what Andre the Giant has cooked up now. He's biting him. He said that he had been working out with the incredible Hulk Hogan, and Hulk had been teaching him a few things, and that may be one of the things.
You said at the start of the broadcast, Rod, why is the referee explaining the rules to them? You're right. They haven't paid attention to anything.
Patera tags off to Bobby Heenan. Heenan kicking away. The Giant looking to tag off, working his way up. He sees it. Heenan grabs a hold of Bobby the Brain Heenan's head and drives that big right hand and almost drives Heenan through the canvas. Here's Hulk Hogan entering the ring. And oh, how quickly things turn. Oh, my. Patera to get a taste of it now. Bockwinkel is going to be next. A judo chop, or karate as you will, by Andre the Giant. Drove Bockwinkel to his knees. Andre the Giant, let's see, who does he have in that corner behind him? Bobby the Brain Heenan. Leo Nomellini forcing Bockwinkel across the ring. Hulk Hogan comes in and says, okay, come on. Come on, Bockwinkel, let's go. Meantime, all this time, Andre the Giant looks like he's just relaxing. And what he's doing, he is squashing one Mr. Bobby Heenan behind him into the turnbuckle.
Where is Bobby?
He's hidden back there somewhere. Bockwinkel comes over to help out, and the Giant has them both wrapped up. Oh, the head knockers. Another one by the Hulk. Now the tag off, and here comes the Giant. And the Giant's first move is a headbutt to Duncum. Then he works on both Bockwinkel and Heenan, and then Ken Patera. A headbutt to Patera, and back goes Patera to the corner. He bangs again Bockwinkel and Heenan together. And here it is now, one-on-one. Heenan, as he drives, the Giant driving Heenan into the corner, right into Bockwinkel. Then he turns around and floors big bad Bobby Duncum. Now he goes back to work again on Heenan and Bockwinkel. And Patera, trying to beat on the stomach of the Giant from Grenoble, gets absolutely nowhere. Talk about momentum and surge and counter-surge. We've seen it here in this one. The Giant tags off after introducing Bockwinkel to Duncum and vice versa. Here, Hogan is back in. That arm is all right. The big boot into the face of big bad Bobby Duncum. Oh! Duncum, or yes, Duncum being covered by Hulk Hogan. Two. He did not get three. All six men in the ring. Patera and Hogan. Patera came out on the short end. Duncum and Andre the Giant. Duncum comes out on the short end. Patera gets the Giant boot in the face. And now Andre the Giant picks up the Hulk and puts him over Duncum. Now Nomellini down, counting one, two, and three. It's all over. Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant have defeated the combination of Bockwinkel, Big Bad Bobby Duncum, Ken Patera, and Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, there you have it. The eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. King of the Battle Royals, and not too bad of a tag team partner.
Well, he's a wonderful tag team partner. I think he wrestled with me four times, and we didn't lose a match. And it was great to have him in your corner when the big guy was back there behind you.
Speaking of being in the corner, he had an enormous, enormous capacity.
Yeah.
You must have some stories about
Chris Taylor, 6'5", 400 pounds, Iowa State wrestler, Olympic champion, and national collegiate champion twice. Challenge Andre the Giant to a beer drinking contest in Kansas City after the matches. They go to the tavern. Make a long story short, Chris's 122nd bottle of beer, he slid off the stool onto the floor. Andre the Giant was on his 147th bottle. The time was closing time, and he asked the bartender, "I need two bottles of wine to take to my room."
That was Andre. He was a massive man and a giant of a man, and we miss him dearly.
Yes, and a jolly giant.
Well, next week on the Legends of the AWA, we've got another superstar for you. Take a look.
Legends of the AWA has been brought to you by your local